That boy got that crack, man. All right, so we are back. It's the new Canadian music video releases. It's your boy Friday Ricky Dread, aka Media Rick, aka Biography Rick, and we're back with a list of new hot music videos. Now, before we start this video here, I need you to please subscribe, hit that subscription button below, as well as that notification bell next to it, so you know when we're dropping new videos, and we're dropping new videos every single day, sometimes two times, three times a day. Now, while you're down there, make sure to hit that join button so you can become a member of the We Love Hip Hop Network's channel, all right? With the membership, you'll be able to get early previews on videos as soon as we upload them to the channel. You'll be able to get discounts on merchandise. You'll be able to get music video postings as soon as your videos drop on any of our social media pages, including our booming We Love Hip Hop Instagram pages and more. So make sure to hit that join button and make sure to hit that notification bell so you know when we're dropping new videos. Now, this what you're going to be seeing here is going to be a list of all the new Canadian music videos that have dropped within the last week, the last 7 days, all 500 views and up. And we need you, the people, to decide who is going to be the number one video in Canada this week. All right, so get in the comments below, comment gang strong. Let us know who your favorite track is or who your favorite artist is on the list that we're going to be playing. And then we're going to be tabulating those votes and letting you know who is going to be the number one video in Canada on the World's Most Smoked Out Podcast Thursday morning on all audio streaming platforms. So comment gang scrum. At the end of this video here, you're going to be getting a special treat. Instead of our industry tips this week, we're going to be giving you a full biography of Tory Lanez, his life from beginning to where we are now. Okay, I'm hoping that I got all the facts right and I got all the facts in there. So if you want to see a long video, make sure to tune in to the end of this video to get all the facts on Tory Lanez. All right, the beat that you're hearing in the background right now, that's courtesy of Steppa the Don Diggity. Now, congratulations to Steppa the Don Diggity. He is the winner of the Match Pipes Prize. He won himself a match pipe as well as the tray, the crusher, and a whole bunch of other accessories courtesy of Match Pipes at matchpipes.com if you want to get your hands on one of those. And his beat is one of the beats that are in the Respect the Process Rap Challenge. Now, there's a lot of people who have been in the challenge already, and I want to give some shout out to some of the people who are in the challenge who are going to be going on to the next round. Big shouts out to Devontae Fresh, to Ooze Dog, The Dying Thief, Ish the Official, Ola OT, Sound Off, I Am H, as well as Murder 54. All right, now we're going to be letting y'all know who out of these guys here, who are out of these rappers on the list, are going to be going on to the next round so that they'll be battling each other to get onto the finals. And there are also other people who are in the challenge right now. There's a few more. Big shout out to C Rose. Big shout outs to a lot of other rappers who are in the challenge right now. So if you want to get yourself in a challenge, make sure to send us a 1 minute video of you spitting your hottest bars over one of the beats that are available on our SoundCloud page, and send it to our email address at welovehiphoptoronto@gmail.com. Again, I'm going to repeat that. That's welovehiphoptoronto@gmail.com. All right, hashtag respect the process. But no more long talking. Let's get to these music videos. New music video releases. Let's go.
Shirex run another one. Tater in my past life. Cause I tell her to do it, ain't no conversation. Semi-automatic, homie. Only time will tell the difference between strong and all the weak. Do me dirty, no more love, lead the talking to the streets.
It came from the streets, it was something E reckless
too. Got my stick up in the booth. Never switch up on my crew, don't fuck with L so I can't lose. Trap boy, do not follow.
Got no time for shit. Dirty Diana, I drop a 4 in the fan. Dirty Amanda, dirty bitch, so I scammed her. She threw it back for the
your door, I deliver cold feet. I seen them shovel 4 or 5, this ain't no spinner. I do this, no beginner. I chose to be a winner or original.
On my chest, who I'm froze up, who I'm froze up. We can do this together, we can do this forever. But I ain't tryna.
My bitch with a fat ass, shorty shake that up on FaceTime. Niggas hate through the grapevine, but I'm posted up with the K9.
Do Ice Cube, yeah, my style. Feel like I'm robbing banks of TT right now. Slippity slide,
look. Bounce fresh like Mentos,
popping like pimples. Beer sick flows, trust me, your ting knows. Make it look so simple, like a pimp bro. Like Pablo, watch
for wrapped in the plastic. This ain't a movie, just cut all the acting. Design a bag, we don't wear it for fashion. I got class, but I never took classes.
I still remember the last time I held you. I look into your eyes, get out of what I do for you.
Deposit the check, I laugh at it. Cause soon as it clear, I'm cracking it. My plug, he speak 2 different languages.
Do you love hip hop? Do you love hip hop?
All right, so let's get to our industry tips. And as promised, this week we're going to be going through a biography of the rapper Tory Lanez, or rapper slash singer Tory Lanez. Now, I've been inspired to do this. You know, I watched the Tory Lanez Quarantine Radio on YouTube Live. It was an amazing show, 2-hour show. I suggest you check it out, where he performed in an empty place, an empty club, empty arena, but had it posted on YouTube Live where people were donating, were getting their comments read. And he performed a very, very thorough show of singing and rapping at the same time. And, you know, I just decided, you know what, we got to do something, put some respect on Tory Lanez's name. So, a lot of wiki facts in here. However, we're going to try to keep it as quick as possible. But do remember, we're going to be doing a long one today. So, born Daystar Peterson in Brampton. Okay, Daystar Peterson was born in July 27th of 1992 to Bajan father Sunstar and mother Luea, Guyanese mother Lulela. Made up a family of 6, he was the youngest, with older sisters Zoe, Destiny Peterson, who we've interviewed on the We Love Hip Hop Network. Bro.
Yeah, that's my big brother.
So how was it growing up with Tory Lanez?
Same as it was growing up with all the rest of my brothers. They was annoying as shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, I just remember singing in the car and stuff, and they would always tell me to shut up. Like, my singing was getting on their nerves. Like, you know what I'm saying? No.
Older brothers Wolfgang Peterson, Hollywood Souls, also interviewed a We Love Hip Hop alumni.
Tory Lanez.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, where do you place in that 6-sibling family? You're like the middle child in a way.
No, I have one older sister.
Okay.
And then, yeah. Then
so you're like the second oldest middle child, basically.
Yeah.
And Yoko Gold, okay? So he was the youngest of 6 in that family. He was born in Toronto, and his family moved to Montreal when he was very young, and that's where he was raised in his early childhood. Before moving to Miami, Florida, Daystar was known to practice and refine his skills through his childhood before tragically finding out his mother died to a rare disease, okay? Mother dying to a brain aneurysm. She suffered with brain aneurysms back in the days, and he's been, you know, noted through his music to describe that the chain of events that happened that led up to when his mother died. Okay, following his mother's death, his father began working as an ordained minister and a missionary, causing them both to frequently move throughout the United States. Daystar's father remarried and had some more kids, so Tory has some half siblings as well, and the family moved to Atlanta. Now the name. In Atlanta, he met his friend Hakeem, and at the time, Hakeem was a janitor. Daystar's nickname Lanez was given to him by Hakeem, as you know, referring to how he used to be a thrill seeker, always getting into trouble, mucking around the streets, you know, playing through the lanes in the traffics with a skateboard. So he got the nickname Lanez. He started rapping after his cousin gave him a major, major ass whooping in Madden. Okay, he ended up stomping out of the crib, went into the garage, and began writing his first rhyme. Probably something Madden, some Madden bars, something Madden related. But that was the first time that Tory Lanez decided he was gonna pick up the pen and become
become a rapper. He gave himself the nickname Notorious, which is a reference to his favorite rapper back in the days, the Notorious B.I.G. Okay, in the end, he ended up cutting down the Notorious, and he cut it down just to Tory, okay? Hence coming up with the name Tory Lanez. At age 16, Tory dropped out of the 10th grade, and he would be started performing, you know, doing street concerts, popping up all over the place, doing freestyles. He started getting into a singing around age 17, but he never had any formal vocal training, okay? Daystar also goes by the name Argentina Fargo. In an interview, he said, "When I put the foreign and the banking together, it's like foreign money. I'm a Canadian dude walking around America. When you look at me, you're looking at foreign money. So I call myself Argentina Fargo." Nice name. Like foreign money. He also drew inspiration from people like Brandy, Mr. Hit It First, Ray J, and many other R&B singers. Okay, he calls his style Swavy, which he explains as a combination of singing and rapping, okay? The Swavy style.
All those three in one would be Swavy, you know? So it's just like that, yeah. I like to fuse all the music and make it, you know, my own.
So let's talk about some of Tory's struggles. In 2006, Lanez was sent to live with his cousin in Jamaica, Queens, New York because of his behavior issues. Daystar then was forced to return back to Toronto with his grandmother. In a 2015 interview, he explains, since his grandmother refused to take care of him, he was on his own from the age of 15. In the interview, he explains he ended up moving into to downtown Toronto with some dudes that he didn't really know. He came into the house, didn't realize how things was. Fighting with his friends daily, that's what made him become a man, and he had to fend for himself in every situation. With no dad around, no grandmother to take care of him, mom dead, he had a lot of different things going on, and you know, he was basically homeless at the time, just, you know, knocking around the streets of Toronto, okay? Around 2009, he dropped his first mixtape, TL to TO, you know, short for ATL to Toronto. And he also took his first shot at Drake at that time and on that mixtape.
Why your man counting ones, honey? Without Wayne, he's still dealing with young money.
Around the time, Tory was advised by a friend to call the polarizing Toronto promoter Freddie Fame to hear his music, and from there, Freddie Fame started managing him. Fame claims that he brought Tory Lanez to Atlanta to make the connections, getting him into studios, venues, open mics, and all types of different places, and getting him all types of different connections.
To the end of the contest, I guess, and from there, you started working with him. Brought him to Atlanta, and then...
Are we talking about
Tory Lanez?
We're talking about Tory Lanez?
Yeah.
Oh, that was...
Am I getting my facts wrong?
Yeah.
So how did you meet him in the first place?
Tory Lanez straight up called me. And he said, "Hey, just listen to my music. If you like it, let's do something." I listened. I said, "Let's do something."
Okay.
And that's pretty much how it went. It wasn't even back and forth. It was like, "Yup, let's go."
Eventually, the two had a disagreement, and Freddie Fame returned back to Toronto, leaving Tory Lanez in ATL to continue his journey. A lot of his early videos at the time, around the TL to TO times and the different mixtape times, were actually filmed by Brampton rapper Raz Freshco, which you can hear explaining in this interview clip from the We Love Hip Hop podcast right now.
Wow. Yeah. Huh? So I shot the video, you know what I'm saying? Shout out to Brampton. This nigga Lanez actually shot the video.
Really?
This is when Lanez was out in Brampton. He shot the video.
That's a Toronto hip hop fact right there.
Oh, wow. Now, some of the collaborations, let's talk about some of the collaborations that Tory Lanez has done before he blew up and post blowing up with Canadian artists. Now he has two different tracks with Pressa, you know, Oh My, and one of Pressa's biggest hits, Canada Goose, both featuring Tory Lanez. He has a track with Classified, or featured on Classified's track, Cold Love. He has a track with Mazari, Number One. He has tracks with Syf. He has tracks with multiple Canadian artist. So big up to Tory Lanez for being the kind of guy who does a lot of collabos. Not to mention that he has collabos with multiple international artists, multiple American artists. He's very accessible when it comes to getting his pen and getting his feature bag on. Now, the Sean Kingston connection, okay, as we move on into Tory Lanez history. Because after his first mixtape in 2010, Sean Kingston heard the TL to TO mixtape and he approached Tory Lanez about getting him on his label, okay? He put him on his label Time Is Money. Around the time before that, he bought him on tour with him while he was touring with Justin Bieber and got Tory's first really, you know, his first taste of getting that big stardom, okay, getting in those big stages, those big arenas, you know, getting to come on stage, do some songs during the Sean Kingston set, and from there the union was made. At 18, he signed to Sean Kingston's label Time Is Money, and then from there he released a slew of mixtapes before he dropped his first album, including Playing for Keeps, Just Landed, One Verse One Hearse, Mr. One Verse Killa, Mr. Peterson, Chicks Tape 1, Swavy, Ignorant Shit, Sincerely Tory, Conflicts of My Soul, The 416 Story, Chick Tapes 2, Lost Cause, Chicks Tapes 3, and The New Toronto. All this during the time when him and Mr. Jafakin, Sean Kingston, were still parring. By The New Toronto 2, Sean Kingston and Tory had seemed to parted ways. I've been trying to do my due diligence to scurry through the internet, to dig through the internet streets to try to find out why Tory Lanez and Sean Kingston parted ways. The only thing that I can find though is from a 2016 interview that he did with Natasha Castles live on Live 101.5 in Phoenix, where he called Sean Kingston a good kid.
So I got out that deal when I was 21. I wouldn't give him the, you know, the credit of you gave me success. Mm-hmm. You know, you gave me a platform, which mm-hmm. is great, but you didn't give me success. We all know that. But you're a good dude, good kid.
I know.
All right. But in 2015, he signed a joint venture deal with Mad Love through Interscope Records. Mad Love is owned by super producer Benny Blanco, who is responsible for a multitude of hits, including hits for people like Ed Sheeran, Justin Bieber, Halsey, Katy Perry, Maroon 5, Kesha, Rihanna, and more. All right, but with that, he started doing the label thing. Being signed to Interscope, that is when he decided to drop his first album, I Told You, okay? Now let's talk about beefs. In 2010, Lanez posted a video challenging fellow Canadian rapper Drake of who he rumored to be related to. The video featured him denying these rumors and announcing a $10,000 challenge.
Let's set the record straight. I'm not Drake's little brother, I never have. Now Drake, yeah. I get compared to you on a daily basis, and it's an honor, I like your music. But I got 10 G's here that says you will love mine. And if for any reason you don't like my music, 10 G's is yours.
While showing Drake respect, Lanez again challenged him, but only if Drake would listen to some of the tracks from his second mixtape, Playing for Keeps. Lanez also claimed that if Drake did not like it, he would personally give him $10,000 afterwards, taking multiple subs and non-subs on The New Toronto 2, his debut album, I Told You, Liddy again on the Meek Mill feature that he had, interviews, freestyles, and more. So from there, it just became shot after shot after shot after shot after shot. Drake finally responded on his 2016 album Views on tracks like Western Flows when he rapped bars like, don't let that newfound fame cloud your judgment to talk loosely, or y'all was too busy face screwing on waist movements, you was TTC Metro, I had the place booming, as well as a bunch of other subs sprinkled all throughout the album that y'all should go check out yourself. As well as on the More Life album, he had bars on Do Not Disturb, where he raps, if we do a song, it's like taking my kids to work with me. And You Overnight Celebrities, You One Day Stars, where he used Tory Lanez's name in the sub and gave him some really poignant, stinging bars, showing Tory Lanez that he's been paying attention to the smoke and finally responding, okay? Now, in May of 2017, the two finally met up after apparently things got kind of spooky and the famous picture emerged of the two united as a Toronto rapper united front, all right? Still no collabo to this day, but hey, you never know.
Is there any possibility of you guys ever getting on a track together?
Well, he's in town right now.
Yeah, apparently he.
Let's talk about some of the albums that Tory Lanez has done over the years to bring him to where we are now. He dropped the I Told You album that came out in 2016. He then he came back in 2018 with the Memories Don't Die album, and then followed up with the Love Me Now album also in 2018. He dropped his Chicks Tapes 5 finally in 2019, and finally he is here with a new Toronto 3, okay? Let's talk about some of the wins, some of the losses. Okay, some of the losses and knock on Tory Lanez. He's been known to be called a style shifter, being called a baby Drake, Travis Scott Light, shout out to Academics. He's been called an R&B singer that raps when he started clearly as a rapper who actually has bars and a lot of flows. Okay, he's been caught stealing bars. You know, his hand got caught in a cookie jar, stealing bars from Don Q in 2019 when Tory Lanez went on the Funk Flex Hot 97 radio show and used bars that were used prior by Don Q on the same radio station, on the same radio show. But a back and forward started going on. This was during the time when Tory Lanez was deciding, you know what? I don't like everybody thinking that I'm just an R&B singer. And he went on a rap tirade. He went to every radio station. He did a bunch of freestyles going at a lot of different people. And in the end of the day, he got spanked by a girl. But there's also the Holt Renfrew incident.
Say hello. Yeah, we balled out your shit. We walked in the store. He didn't think we was going to buy nothing. We balled out his shit.
Okay. In the Holt Renfrew incident, he was inside the Holt Renfrew. He says allegedly that, you know, the money was given to him by the label so that he can go buy wardrobe for a music video. He was walking around the store, him and his crew. One of the employees were looking at him a little bit shady. He confronted the employee, but instead of walking out the store and not buying anything, he decided, I'm going to buy everything anyway to show everybody I got this kind of money. He got flack from that, from the media, from the internet. The internet started just jumping on his back to the point where he ended up getting Donkey of the Day from Charlemagne the God. People say that he can be arrogant a little bit too much at times, where, you know, Tory Lanez gets into interviews. Sometimes he's not as humble as people want him to be, but hey, talk your shit. That's how I feel about it. He can be a little bit brolic at times too, people say. You know, he's had public fights with people like Travis Scott. He's been seen punching fans after stage diving in a 2018 show. And, you know, Tory Lanez has started building up a reputation of a guy not to play with. Okay, a lot of people say that he might have what people call Napoleon complex or short man syndrome, trying to prove because he's not a super big guy in stature that he's not the guy to fuck around with. So, you know, watch out for Tory Lanez, even myself for saying what I'm saying, because he might just run up on me and snuff me in the face. Some of the wins, getting off of Sean Kingston's label. Okay. One of the biggest wins for Tory Lanez was at first going independent before actually getting back into another deal, but it was a good step in a good direction from getting off of Mr. Jafakin's label and getting, parting ways with Sean Kingston, especially with the fact that Sean Kingston started going through a downslide afterwards, going broke, having multiple videos about him going broke. There is, it seems right now, a song that's floating around the internet right now with Sean Kingston featuring Tory Lanez. So I don't know if that's something that Tory Lanez has authorized. I don't know if they've made friends. I'll be doing some more investigating to see what we can find out about this. Now, getting the world's attention off of the talent, hard work. Okay, at the end of the day, Tory Lanez has not taken no handouts from anybody. He wasn't put on, he wasn't getting a cosign from a Rockefeller or a Rough Riders or Cash Money. He came up on his own. You know, he connected with somebody like Sean Kingston, who wasn't really super respected in the hip hop world. So it's not like we would give a shit about him, but he was still able to separate himself and make a name for himself off of his hard work, off of his relentlessness, off of doing multiple interviews, multiple freestyles, and multiple features before he got to the point where he is now, okay? He's very accessible and he's very charismatic online.
okay? It's very proven when it comes to stuff like Quarantine Radio and different things like that. He has a multitude of interviews where he's, you know, having a lot of fun and being very charismatic when it comes to the radio host or whoever he's speaking to, whether it's online or at a radio station. So that definitely works in his favor. Having a fire pen, all right, gets him all the writing gigs that he needs behind the scenes, you know, being known to write a lot of hooks for people behind the scenes, as well as R&B songs. He's probably penning out a lot of bars for you guys behind the scenes too. Tory Lanez will always be able to eat, whether his music is hot or not, from the publishing checks that he's received from putting down his pen work behind the scenes. So kudos to him for that, okay? Getting off of his deal finally with Interscope, he's now independent. You know, he's being approached by multiple labels, throwing major figures at him to try to sign him into a new major label deal. And right now he's coasting, doing a great job as an independent artist, especially with the release of his new album, New Toronto 3. So big up to him. You know, during these times of social isolation or self-isolation, he's taken that to his advantage. He started the Quarantine Radio, where he, you know, he's just doing a broadcast from the crib. He's got girls twerking on camera, which I'm not gonna show here on this YouTube video so we don't get demonetized. And, you know, just having people do talent contests and all types of stuff. From where he decided to finally transition that into YouTube, you know, him and Leo Korns might have spoken behind the scenes and, you know, worked something out so that he can be able to get his songs played completely on the YouTube channel, be able to get people to donate. You know, he was able to do a 2-hour concert and basically bring that Quarantine Radio that he was doing from the crib over to the YouTube streets. So big up to Tory Lanez for that. In the end of the day, it's extremely difficult to blow up in the US, okay? Especially as an artist who is not from the US. You got people coming from other countries. You know, you got Canada, who is a country that we have a country of 30 million plus people in population. Becoming a household name is way harder to get into a place where there's 300 plus million people that you got to become a household name in. So kudos to Tory Lanez for being able to do that. Okay, you got artists from places like Russia, like Oxymoron. You got people like Skepta from the UK, who are huge in their respective countries. However, they have not been able to make themselves household names in the United States, okay? So to be able to do that from another country is a big, big deal. And there's not many artists who are from Canada right now at the moment who are household names. We got a very popping scene, we're bubbling, we got a lot of rappers who got a huge buzz, but becoming a household name in the United States is a whole nother level. So in the end of the day, big up to Tory Lanez. I know this is not all the information that you can have on him, or it would end up being a 1 hour in a 1 hour video. But if there's any more information that you guys might have about Tory Lanez that you want to put into the comments, let me know below. What have I missed? What have I gotten wrong? And also let me know if you want to see more videos like this, where we do a breakdown on a Canadian artist and give them their flowers while they're still here to smell it. All right. Make sure to leave your votes for the videos that we have from earlier in the montage video. We're going to be letting you know who is going to be the number one video in Canada this week. So let us know in the comments below. Comment gang strong. And do remember to follow me on all social media platforms at Friday Ricky Dread. That's D-R-E-D. Make sure to hit up our website, welovehiphop.ca. And make sure to follow us on Instagram at We Love Hip Hop Network. Same. It's your boy Friday Ricky Dread, a.k.a. Media Rick, a.k.a. Biography Rick. And we out.